So, very warm welcome everybody to our session, and thanks for your interest and thanks for joining, and greetings from the south of Germany, from Stuttgart. It's always challenging when being the last slot on the agenda and in between you and lunch, but I'm confident that Hannes and myself will make the best out of it and take you to a journey through the company called Trust. Trust with double that. And what is trust all about? It's about taking all the good things that have been built by the IDSA and apply that to the market. In terms of flow through this presentation, so I will go through the first four or five slides. Then we look under the hood. So what's under the hood? And that when Hannes will more or less take the lead, I will get back to speech on the last slide. And at the end, we are having one question to you, and we're looking forward to get your answer on that last question. And so now, starting with the market and looking at the market. So I myself, I spent more than half of my business career on working on digital products and solutions, and enabling companies to digitize. From digital identities to cloud, from cybersecurity to ecosystems and data privacy. I did that across industries. I worked in automotive, I worked in telecommunication, governmental, payment. And what's common all across these use cases, all across these industries, it's one thing, right? They don't talk to you when you don't have a business case. They don't talk to you and they don't have a business plan. So otherwise they were not listening to you. So what do you do when you're providing tools, helping companies to digitize, and they tell you they need a business plan? So in fact, you become an industry expert to tell your customers how they can build new digital business models and make money based on your products. And that is, you know, when you realize that your customers need digital services, they need data, they need input from other players within their industries or outside their industries to run their own digital offerings and to monetize the data. I mean, just to focus on one example, which is automotive/mobility. A connected car needs connectivity. A connected car needs payment to pay for digital services. A connected car obviously needs energy. It needs to quote-unquote talk to smart cities. You need to download, to onboard, to enable digital media inside the vehicle. So all these offerings, it's going far beyond, in this case, the automotive industry. Mechanisms like that, it's not just for the automotive, they are valid for the other industries as well. Whether it's logistics or the end-to-end transportation of goods, or whether it's about Industry 4.0, you know, the manufacturing of goods across, you know, across ecosystems of manufacturing plants. And once you realize that you really depend on other players within your ecosystem or other players outside your ecosystem, then you need to act, right? You need to say, look, how do I get this information? And you have two choices. The first choice is you insource all those domains and you build up your competence yourself in-house. When doing that, you go outside your comfort zone. You go outside your expertise. A large company may be able to do that. A smaller company, like a small and medium enterprise, that is very specialized on their specific product, will have difficulties to really embrace everything which is digital, right? So the second choice is you really start to collaborate with other players, again, within your own industry or outside your industry. And this is actually the way what we understand with ecosystems. It's when you are on the way to digitize and to digitalize, and you really want to leverage the value propositions coming from other players, and you prefer to not just build your own digital silo. Now let's assume everybody agrees and understands the need of ecosystem. So what is it that you need then to build ecosystems? So we see two things that are needed to build those. The first one is, yes, you need to have the technology in place, but not just any technology, because any company can connect to any other company peer-to-peer, no problem, that's state of the art today. But what you need is, you need a standard technology across players, across industries, across ecosystems that allows an easy integration and an easy scaling of the ecosystem. So onboarding partners easily. At the same time, it needs security, it needs privacy, and it needs all services which are needed for an end-to-end building of services. And the most important thing is really you need a standard. So that's the one thing, you need technology. But technology alone doesn't build an ecosystem. Because ecosystem is about collaboration, ecosystem is about commercial trust. So when you share your data, you sell data, you exchange data, you trade data, you need to have commercial trust. And commercial digital trust is the basis so that you know that you can keep the ownership of your data. You know that you are acting according to the regulations, maybe GDPR or other regulations. And you need to have the right tools in place to basically monitor trust, to build technical trust and to monitor technical trust. So it's really like trust is good, but control is better. So you need to be able to see what's happening with your data, what happened with your data. And then this now starts to become a circle. So you need to write technology in place to build commercial trust. And this is basically an unbreakable circle. The use of ecosystem technology requires commercial trust, and commercial trust requires the right technology to prove the trust. And this is actually where the company trust, again, with a double Z, gets into the game. So we deliver those two ingredients. We provide on the basis of the IDS standard, trusted infrastructure as a service, of course, certified, allowing the easy scaling of ecosystems. A needed enabler allowing companies of all sizes to build ecosystem or join existing ecosystem, leveraging the IDS standard will give you the tools to enable traceability, transparency, and the trusted anchor for your data. So you see who did what with the data, who is allowed to do what with the data, and you know for sure that the company you claim to be is really the company they claim to be. And how do we fit in? How do we see ourselves? So our mission is to deliver an easy and consumable, scalable way of the IDS standards. So we see ourselves almost like IDS as a service or standard as a service. So the IDSA is giving the technical framework. Gaia-X is providing a kind of legal, political, commercial framework. But when you really want to consume this service, you want to build the ecosystems to go really to business, to monetize it, to make money out of it, you need to consume it. And again, as said before, larger enterprises, they can easily, they could in theory easily build their own connectors and connect through that type of standard. But all smaller and medium types of enterprises, for them, this is not an option. I mean, they don't have the horsepower to go for this in-house. So these companies actually rely on a service provider that is providing this type of services let's say, off the shelf, easy to consume. So that was the initial story on how we see ecosystems, why ecosystems are important. And now let's look under the hood. Let's see how it works. And let's see what we deliver, in fact. So and for that, I would say over to you, Hannes.
Okay. So then let's take a deeper look into what we provide and what services are necessary for you and for interact with a digital ecosystem. So here's a list of services what we want to give to you in the future, and now also some digital services. And first is the Trust Connector. It's the EDSA connector. Yeah, so you need it. We provide a clearinghouse for controlling is better than trust. So you can monitor the transaction and whatever you want. So like a little bit PayPal 2.0, maybe. Then search and discovery. This is EDSA. It's named Broker. I think you need a search directory for services and data. So you can find the right data outside in the data spaces. Knowledge, we want to help you to install and to use the connector and the TrustBox. We named it TrustBox is a virtual engine with a Dropbox and connector inside. So it's a little bit more than the connector alone. Value exchange is this is the biggest part there, I think so. So you can attach terms of use for the data, and this can be also billing, but not only billing. It's a little bit more than billing in a normal internet flow. So now you are able to attach terms of use to the data, and we will help you with defining also the terms of data. And marketplace is an app store, maybe, so that you can use inside the TrustBox some apps and e-programs and whatever. They help you to customize your data, to analyze your data, whatever. So these are the promised services. Now, how it works? It's like actually in the normal road traffic, so the German Autobahn, whatever. If you build a car, you have to build it and to approve it according to the regulation. So the car must be homologated, and this is the correspondence to the certification of the EDSR certification. So you have to certificate the connector and the TrustBox, whatever. After this, your car or TrustBox is certified. You can use it on the public roads or European roads, whatever. But one time before you can drive the car on the street, you need a license plate. So you have to register the car at the whatever it means road traffic office, whatever, so that you get the license plate. This corresponds with a token from the DAPS in our systems. So this is a unique identifier also for you. And after you are onboarded, you can on the DAPS, you can get this unique identifier, your license plate. And if you get them, you have an trust box or a car to drive on the data autobahn, whatever. So the next step is you go outside and search some other partners, so where you can get data or you can sell data. So you have to find in the broker and whatever different trust boxes, connectors, whatever. And if you find them in the dark, you will connect them, and so you the dark will check if the license plate is correct and the certification is the right one and so on. And so you get them, if it's all right, so you get them security token back. And you can also define if the terms of use for your data. And with this token, you can now take and peer-to-peer communication between the two trust boxes or connectors, and so you can share your data with some different parts, not only one-to-one connection, also you can connect many trust boxes. So you have the possibility to do end-to-end connectors and send them with private messages and change data and take terms of use also there. So then the trust box as a service, it means you have your own data silos, whatever, and you can and take them into the ecosystem or more than one ecosystems with the connector or the trust boxes when you connect your private data into one trust box to one connector, and then you have the possibility to change the data in the EDSR or whatever ecosystem. So it's easier for you that you change the data with your private data and you only give the secure data outside, and you don't have to open your private silos. So it's easier also to integrate it. You can also put it on an multi or embedded system, so you can install it on hardware if you want, and so you can connect machines directly to the ecosystems, and you can send the data where they are provided now and directly into the the whole ecosystem, not only one ecosystem, maybe more than one ecosystem, but you can provide your machine data in this ecosystem. And now you can use it also as a database for data spaces. So you can leave the data where they are created. And you can also use it like a database, but you don't need to send the data to a big database and compress them there or whatever. So you can get the data directly from all of these data spaces and can use it like a big database also. This is also one of the features of the trust box. If you use it in this in this way, so and you can use it also in your data private data center, whatever. So you have many possibilities to use the data chain, the data, to host the data. So it's better like this. So you, if you you can do it, it with one big trust box at the door opener for the provider center, host provider, or you can give the all separate connectors and trust boxes, whatever, for small piece of data. But you can also spend to hold the data to one trust box, and then you connect the whole ecosystems outside. So you have many parts, possibilities to do it, and every time the clearinghouse is inside, so you can do a protocol and for every transaction, and so you can take a look on it, what's happened there. It's at what time one has transport one of this data to another trust box, whatever. And maybe you can do it in the future also, like to provide the data to a third party company. They can check the whole protocol and like PayPal, whatever, so that both parties have to write to to check. It's all ready on the data transport, and can I get the data? Get I the data that I want to, and did the other parts get the data that I sent them and whatever? So you can check it directly in the clearinghouse. So that is the next step. What we also provide as a service, but the trust box is. At the end, a virtual machine with a Docker container and a connector inside, and you can use it also with in Kubernetes, so that you can move the connector and the trust box every time to different cloud providers or whatever, and you are every time scalable if you want. All what Kubernetes is also provided, you can use it there. So this is the biggest part, I think, in the future, to use the boxes also. And now here a little bit how it works in real systems. So one company has a customer, and both use a trust box. So the consumer spends data to the company, and the company has to store the data for maybe 10 years or whatever. So the data can be sent from the trust box, consumer trust box, to the company trust box, and this possibility is now that if the consumer delete his trust box, the company has also stored the data, the spent data from the customer, and it's clear, and you can provide every time the data from the customers, and the customer also is connected with the company connector and trust box, so that he can hold also the data inside that the company provided to the customer. So both contact connectors provide the data, believing the customers and some transaction to the company. So if one of these parts is deleting his trust box, there's no problem, because the spent data are also hosted in the own trust box. So, and maybe the customer has a new address or whatever, so in the company gets in real time the data, and also stored in his trust box. So it works like GDPR system, so that you are every time a secure data storage for your personal data by the companies. And if the data should be deleted, the whole system is delete the data, use of terms with the clearinghouse, whatever. So you have to write to delete the data if the terms is over, and you are sure that the data are deleted. So because the trust box is synchronized yourself. So maybe that, Michael, you can take the next part for the ecosystem.
Yes, Hannes, thanks. Sorry for the audio. I hope it's better now. If not, let me know. So you got a brief idea on what our mission is, and how we're implementing it, what we are doing. But last but not least, just to be precise, what we are not doing. So we neither interfere with your business as such, nor with your applications, nor with the data that is coming out of your applications. So we enable secure data exchanges, but we do not look at the payload nor the applications around it. We do not go to B2C, definitely, but we enable B2B to C. And we do not govern any connection. We enable connections. And with that, we are almost through. So we have one last question for the audience. So let's assume you are looking for such a let's say IDSA as a service. What, according to you, could be your preferred model for consuming the service? So I gave you like five different options. So would be interested to hear how you think that could be applicable for your business. And with that, I would like to say thank you and enjoy the rest of the day and stay healthy.